Hello and welcome to another Clan Battle Replay cast. And today I'm featuring ourselves against Junk. And as you maybe have seen in the title, it's about this so-called Wolfpacks or Wolfpack lineup, which is a pretty strong lineup. And if correctly played, I think one of the most powerful. And a lot of clans probably don't know how to deal with it. Yeah. So how do you deal with it? let's go quickly over the lineup. So Junk is bringing Ohio, Stalingrad, Summers, and four Klebers. So that's a lot of firepower in terms of Klebers. But you or we in this case have a strong cruiser setup, means we have still the firepower advantage. The question is just figuring out where is the Wolfpack heading, right? So if you and you always want to avoid to fight the Wolfpack if you don't have numerical advantage or the firepower advantage. So you play it passive in that regard. Losses are calculated in at some point, but obviously you have to kill some of the enemy ships as well. What you want to do is basically, okay, you figure out where the Wolfpack is. So there was a ping by Bauk in the gearing. That's probably his closest RPF location. Means could be that that are the Klebers. And Sturf is now here spotted. That can only be a destroyer since they have only Ohio and Stalingrad. Ohio, okay, is shooting him. And he's popping the radar just to verify his assumption. And there we go, four Klebers. And that means, well, he's not going into a stationary position or something like that. You want to be on the run here, more or less. Because on this side, they have only Hindenburg and himself, plus maybe accompanied by an Ohio. On the other side, which is basically our stronger flank, we have Gearing, the Moin Zhao, Stalingrad. So, you want to avoid such a fight in the start. Let them have C and yeah, figure out what's going on and play more aggressive on the other side. Because as of right now, we have 6 out of 7 ships spotted. That means the enemy Summers is definitely in A. Means these guys can play aggressive. And meanwhile, while they play aggressive, they start farming these 2 ships that are more or less constantly visible. Basically the Stalingrad or the Ohio. Or first the Stalingrad, then the Ohio. So this is basically how you play it. So you get rid of the ships that can establish a crossfire, which enables you to play more freely, and then you just kill Kleber by Kleber, I would say. What the Kleber's goal is basically singling out targets. And by staying close together and support each other, especially, I mean, Ridgeline is a Cyclone map, so Cyclone will be hitting at some point. You basically wanna stay like 10 to or 8 to 10 kilometers away from each other, so you have all good shots and you can support. And also you see this kind of line that is forming. I mean, currently, we don't know exactly where the Klebers are. I was not playing in this game, so I assume they either stayed at sea, but that's pretty pointless because they have to defend against these guys. So they will probably rotate over towards here while these guys are pushing. And at that point, I mean, that's like how this always works. If you see the enemy pushing forces back, then you go with the weak side in and try to do whatever you can on that side. Right, so Sturf going for another radar just to verify if there is a Kleber left, and it doesn't look as if C is any more crowded with Klebers, so it's more or less free, and therefore they are pushing. These guys could play a bit more aggressive, but I guess they are afraid of the Ohio and Stalingrad, I don't know, but especially in the Cyclone they can do it then. And contest A, or maybe our Gearing is also going a bit wider. Obviously, he has to watch out for the radar of the Stalingrad. You don't want to get caught out in the radar, because then the Klebers probably wreck you bit by bit. So you want to play it really, really safe. And yeah, as I said, Sturf is going in. occupying this sea cap together with Masru, who's in Hindenburg here, and yeah. Let's see what comes out of it. It's taking also some pot shots on the Ohio, as I said. Spam the ships that are visible. In this case, this Darlinghurt is having not the greatest time here. By the way, hello, Snackman. And, yeah. That's how it's going. I mean, that's kind of often the flow of the battle. Always these kind of rotations. Okay, you sense some weakness, then you play aggressive. If the enemy is coming to deal with you, well, then you play a bit more passive. And you see, two clippers are coming better back. By the way, don't wonder about that name. Stove Second Daddy. That's kind of a meme. It's a former clan member of ours. He's now playing with junk. And he's doing that to... yeah, harass Sturf in a way. But he doesn't take it so serious. Alright, so... yeah, it's basically what it is. The clippers are coming back. Okay, Sturf won't get out of that situation that easily. So he has to tank for now. And focus obviously on target. In this case, the low HP clipper are the ones that I recommend to get shot at. Masru is trying to support as good as he can. The clippers are also focusing one target by only getting shot by one target as well. So in this case only Sturf is able to. Masru needs to get in a better position to be able to shoot. And Ohio is also close by. Now you see forming kind of a line, and that's how you deal with these kind of setups. I mean, they have firepower, clippers, yes, but they don't have the sustain. And the sustainability, sorry, to like withstand a push on all sides. I mean, this side is pretty weak right now. As I said, this could have happened here way earlier. The Des Moines could have been already here or here, depending. And Stalingrad here, because the only thing they have to fear is like torps, and then only the torps from the summers, and not so much. Any crossfires, because I mean they can push back the Ohio and the Stalingrad in exclamation marks pretty easy. Alright, Sturf reversed behind the island to get a bit more safety and to buy himself a bit more time. It's also about delaying, right? Because that group needs to get into action, so we are getting hold on A. Right now the points balance is still in favor of junk. But that can change pretty quickly. Concentrate fire on the designated target. Because the enemy Stalingrad is about to go down, so that's the first casualty. This Kleber looks pretty low HP. Yeah, and now Masru is taking all the heat right now. Actually, if Klebers are getting low HP, it's not such a bad idea to shoot AP, simply because the saturation kicks in, though the French destroyers have a different saturation model, which allows them to sustain more damage over time, so even without a heal. And yeah, Masru is under big pressure, but as I said, casualties are included every now and then. I mean, we have two caps, they can't do anything about this right now. More or less, I would say. And now it's just about killing. Who's killing whom quicker? And also, like, I mean, Klebers have also, like, this... ability to rush ships by supporting each other kind of close, you also mitigate the danger of that. So we lose our Ohio in the middle, rip Magi. But that doesn't matter, as I said. I mean, the Ohio dies, if the enemy Ohio dies, that means they can play so freely here. don't know what our Sao is doing. Maybe just following the RPF, so the Summers can't even go and get the cap anymore. Now you honestly want to focus the low HP, but here that would be a perfect scenario. The mid part of the Klebers is usually saturated because that's where they hit or get hit the most. Therefore, either AP and overpens will do the job, or you have to hit the front or the mid. But against an actively dodging ship again like the Kleber, that's not always such an easy task to achieve, right? I think with AP he would have been dead, because we're 3 hits. And now he's also going to shoot AP. Problem solved, sir. Just want to make sure that he reduces the number of ships now. But yeah, as I said, the sustain isn't there on the Klebers side. Sturv tries to get away here, but I think, or I doubt that will happen. Yep, Kleber gets one shot off and hits the back of the ship, and therefore kills Sturv. But at that point, it doesn't matter, it's one. So that's, I wouldn't say it's a blueprint, but kind of a scheme with in which you can, Ozao was hunting down the Summers by RPFing him and forcing him away from the cap. But this is kind of a scheme how you can handle this. I mean, in the first place, people are struggling quite a bit with it, because it's new and so on. But, and also on the other hand, I think Junk didn't play it completely correct. They also made some mistakes, otherwise it's really a powerful lineup and really annoying to deal with, to be honest. It's not unbeatable. Depends always on the strengths of the clan. How good are your individually players and how good can you communicate and so on and so on. Therefore, it's not only the lineup which makes this strong. So Junk is not known to be a bad team, so therefore these guys know actually what they are doing and are pretty experienced, and therefore usually are a rough team to fight against, I would say at least. This game they played a bit like, okay, let's play around with our Kleber setup. I mean, I have one more LAN battles video, or maybe two, in which I will feature where we play it with exactly the same lineup, or almost exactly the same lineup, simply because of the reason that we reached Hurricane and therefore can just play Bravo rating and just derp a bit around, and yeah, who cares, right? If you lose, doesn't matter. If you win, well, that's a nice addition, but yeah, definitely fun to watch, and a bit of high speed gameplay there. Okie dokie, yeah, that's it for me. Hope you liked that episode. Yeah, I know it's the last day of clan battles, but yeah, sorry, we didn't face too many of these lineups before, so, and if we did, we also did our fair share of fuck ups. Therefore, they were not so interesting to feature, and yeah, that was definitely a good example how to deal with it. All right, yeah. As I said, bye-bye and see you next time.